What's up, Internet? Anaris here with another exciting StarCraft II broadcast covering the grand finals from LastPlayerStanding.com's third SC2 Open. 48 players, and it all comes down to this best of five for the grand prize. Who's going to take it home? Well, Czech is already down 1-0. Czech is actually playing as the Zerg player down here, the Teal under Baboom Prime. His opponent is none other than Crazy Movin of Team Infinity 7, who so far has had a phenomenal performance in multiple games. So I'm really going to be looking to see how this pans out, as we are on a little bit better of a map for expansion-style play. I'm going to be a little curious to check the timings of the pools, see if they're going to be going for early pools again like they did in game number one. The reason they did that is because Zerg versus Zerg is such a volatile matchup. From the very beginning, you know, you could have a 7 pool. You could have a... Now, in this case, looks like we have a 10 pool coming for both players. And, the action just begins so early. PvP, TVT, you know, PvP, you're going to have engagements early to mid-game. That kind of in-between spot. TVT, you're going to have games that last for about 3 to 6 weeks. And, you know, ZVZ, they start, about the 2:45, 3-minute mark, depending on what strategy people go for. And it's always just so very micro-intensive. You have to have really good scouting to know what your opponent's doing. As Tier 1 Zerg, you know, you've got Zerglings, Banelings, Roaches, and of course Speedlings as well. You can kind of count Speedlings for the first minute and a half or so of the Zerglings being out. But, it's pretty fun to watch it sometimes. As long as the players don't just sit there and macro up for like 45 minutes and not engage at all, then it's usually pretty interesting. Now, here we go with a couple of Zerglings popping out for each player. Now, here's what usually happens. You're going to see the Zerglings pop out, meet somewhere midfield, probably in this platform somewhere roundabouts here. And speaking of which, this tower is going to be very important for this game, by the way. And so, anyways, what's going to happen is you're going to see one player manage to pick off a Zergling or two, and then that person is going to drive his opponent away while, you know, they retreat until they get some reinforcements. Oh, nice move! Crazy move, and actually coming in here with the Zerglings and catching Czech on a split second when he had the move command on those Zerglings. So taking an extra 2 or 3 hits total from those Zerglings ended up giving him the much-needed advantage here in the early game. So now Czech's plan is to pretty much just run these Zerglings around until he can get some reinforcements. Moving forward from there, you know, we don't have any upgrades in the immediate future, not in the next 10 to 15 seconds, but you're going to see him basically try to accumulate a force that can counter what's currently running around here, which is about 6 Zerglings or so, and then he's going to try to get a better position on Crazy Movin and drive him back to his base. And it's just this constant back and forth, and you know, you're going to throw in Banelings, Roaches, whatever else. It kind of reminds me of those Siege games that you played in Warcraft 3, where you just had like 2 giant bases. Dota as well, very similar style. We're just back and forth throwing units into the mix for the first couple minutes of the match. Obviously, it deviates very much and doesn't really look that like that later on in the game, but I always thought that was kind of an interesting dynamic, how that plays out. All we need are the little heroes running around here. Anyways, back to the match. More important things going on. Crazy Movin, now being forced to run up the ramp and pretty much just assume a scouting maneuver here. That's what he's going to be running, and it's actually a nice split. You see, he's trying to keep the bulk of the Zerglings distracted. And that's pretty much to allow these couple of Zerglings to come up here and scout out his opponent's base without having that big batch of Zerglings come up here and clump up where Crazy Movin was trying to scout to. So having those extra Zerglings actually really paid off, splitting them up like that. So now Crazy Movin, what can he do from here? Well, he does have his Baneling Nest on the way. Neither player has an expansion, which I think is pretty interesting, but I mean, not altogether, you know, surprising. Oh, speaking of which, Czech coming over here with one Baneling. Can he actually nail some Zergling kills? Oh, he's going to run to the top of the ramp. Oh, the Queen manages to take it out. Second Queen comes over here to just keep the ramp nice and secure. Look at that. They're even moving in tandem. How awesome is that? So far, units lost. Resources, rather, 206 to 406. So not that huge so far at this early stage of the game. But look at the income, and we can see 20 to 18. As one Overlord has been lost here, that's going to be just a tiny setback, as he did already have one in production But that brings them to 26-26. 34-34 for Crazy Movin' right now. Taking a look at both players' bases, we see they're actually pretty similar in style. We do have a Spinecrawler going down. And I think those Zerglings actually spotted. No, they did not. Wow. Very, very close. Not catching that Baneling nest. But, you know, this Spinecrawler right here will be very important. And speaking of which, oh, look at this. Check is actually going to be going down for an expansion. Notice how it's very close to the timing of this expansion over here. Crazy Movin' dropped his just a little bit earlier because, again, this pressure. He knew that he was in a good spot. Oh, nice hit with the Baneling. Anyways, yeah, Crazy Movin' knew he was in a good spot, having his Zerglings over here on this side of the map, knowing that he could pretty much just deny the expansion, place his own, and keep check contained, at least for the time being. As he continues to morph in more Banelings, we're going to see him pretty much continue to hold this ramp. I don't foresee any serious aggression making its way actually into the main base here, as long as these queens hang around. But with them retreating, these Banelings once again do have to watch out, as check does have a couple of them ringing here. Okay, well, I think he actually ended up netting one additional Baneling kill. All the while, check has tried to run up a few Banelings to send them into the base. We see that a couple of Zerglings will be running in. Again, just distracting. Check's plan here is to try to take out as many Zerglings as possible and leave Crazy's base vulnerable to counterattack. Check is pretty confident that he's going to be able to bust this up, and we see now he is spreading creep, so he's going to be able to drop the defenses down here at the bottom and place the Spinecrawler in a nice defensible position. I say that because it's up against the ramp right here, so Zerglings are not going to be able to get a complete surround. Crazy is still controlling the Watchtower. Check does want to get that information, though. This is, again, so crucial to know when your opponent is going to be coming across the map. Now, Overlords and ZVZ play an incredibly important role in terms of scouting, because with the exception of Overlords getting way too close to the queens like this, the natural expansion, they do provide that invaluable scouting information, even more so than having the Watchtower. As you see, Crazy Movin' is going to be continuing to move his Overlords across the map in a line between the two bases. And again, this is just because Zerg versus Zerg, you really don't have a lot of anti-air until the mid to late stages of the game. And considering just how volatile the early stage is, having as much scouting information as possible early on is just so, so important. Good Baneling control from Crazy Movin', as we did have a possible attack from Check, but, you know, he was not able to really penetrate the mining wall here. Looking at the money, or looking at the income, we see 27-26. The biggest difference here is that Crazy Movin' is currently running on double gas right now. We do have Check coming up with a bunch of new drones, getting ready to come and start working at the natural expansion. And with him going into Tier 2, I'm really going to be curious. Is he going to be going with something like a fast muto? We could see a quick spire. Considering he does have 400 gas just sitting around, he is working on his fourth and final geyser right now. And up here, we see Crazy Movin'. Yep, sure enough, there we go with that spire. Again, you just look at the gas, man, you can just kind of read it for yourself and know a pretty good idea what's going on. Also, another thing that kind of led to that decision was that Check knew from checking out his opponent. Okay, see what I did there. You know, sticking with Zerglings, and he spots the Banelings as well, or the Roaches as well. So he knows that Crazy has not dumped a whole lot of gas into his build, and that's another reason why Check wanted to get up here. He wanted to know as much information about the gas as possible, see if he's in Tier 2, which, I mean, at this point, he darn well better be. But, you know, Check, having scouted that out, sees, okay, this isn't being mined, this wasn't for a while. If I go ahead and get mutas, I'll probably be at a little bit better position in terms of air superiority. But, you know, there's potential for a lot of roaches to be made here for Crazy Movin', and we look and see that more are on the way. The Spire is just about complete. That is a lot of roaches, folks. Let's actually look at the army comparison right now. 92-54. That is a huge quantity. And we look at Check Prime, or Check, rather. We see he's just got a couple Spinecrawlers. That's about it. A few Zerglings, a couple Banelings. The Banelings are going to be good for maybe picking off a pack of Zerglings if they get lucky with their hits. But, oh man, this is going to be really difficult for him to hold off. Oh, here they go. Nice hit right there. Took out, I think, about 8 Zerglings total. 9 mutas on the way, but this is just such a powerful attack, folks. I don't see check really doing a whole lot about this quickly. Because, yes, the Roaches are obviously not able to fire up at those Mutas, but the Mutas aren't going to be working down those Roaches very quickly. Although he is splitting them up now, so I'm going to be a little curious to see if he tries to go for the Hatcher or the Lair, rather. No, he's just going to be going for the drones. This drone line has already been more or less just taken out right there as we see Roaches continuing to work on that line. The Mutas doing what they can. It's only a matter of time, though, folks. It's only a matter of time. You see 18 Zerglings on the way. This is just him trying to mop up. We do see the Lair going down. A couple Mutalists trying to whittle down the army. But having the Mutas split like this really isn't helping a whole lot either. And you see that the Roaches, this is something very smart. I don't necessarily know if Crazy Moving was doing this intentionally. But notice how when he was retreating, the Roaches actually were split up. So, the Glaiveworms were not really bouncing and doing a whole lot of extra damage. Zerglings coming in, trying to get some good control on these Roaches, keep them from kiting around too much. We see that this Lair is 368 health. Will it go down, folks? I think it will. We're at 199, 131. Oh my god, one Roach alive. He manages to save it with 82 hit points. And with Roaches continuing to stream in, we do have a couple more Roaches coming over here. 50, it is gone, folks. Check losing his Lair. A very important part of the base here at this stage of the game. He is now working with one hatchery worth of larvae. No queens. No queens at all. So these Mutas are pretty much his only hope for winning. Let's come up here ahead of the Mutas and take a look at the base. Oh no. Crazy has got two spore crawlers here in the main. He's got two here at the natural, working on an additional one at each base, plus his own Hydralisk Den. This is really gonna... Yep, there's the GG! I was gonna be... It's so difficult for Check to try to pull this attack off. But no, sure enough, we're seeing him go ahead and cancel out. So right now, Check is down 2-0. One more game, and Crazy Moving could force a 3-0 shutout, bringing this series to a close. What's gonna happen? Be sure to tune in next video. You'll find a link the video response down below.